much because the weather's been, you know, a lot of thunderstorms in the afternoon. And on those days that I do go, I typically do crossword puzzles because on the inside, I'm a 90-year-old lady. So, I don't know if I'm going to get around to reading any of them, which is a real shame because that's four books in my suitcase that I really could have, you know, put something else instead, like taken something else back with me in its place. But we'll see. I just want to say that I had to stop just quickly after my intro. I had to stop recording because there was way too much noise outside. And then I recorded the entire video and realized at the end that my phone wasn't on record. So I had all the audio and no video. So that's how my day is going. So the first book that I wanted to read is, I bought it to do research for a true crime case. And some of you have asked me about this case. It's the marked true case from Belgium. And I definitely do want to cover it, but I watched a few documentaries in preparation and took a lot of notes, and every time I sat down to rehearse recording it, I burst into tears. So I don't think I'm quite ready to cover the case yet. It's been so long, and it's really hard, so I'm not quite there yet, but I do really want to record it one day. And this book is by Sabine Dardenne, and it's called I Choose to Live in English. She is a French speaking. She originally wrote it in French. I don't know the French title of it, but in Dutch it is literally translated as I Was 12 and Cycling to School. So she is one of Mark Dutroux's victims. So I'll give you a little bit of background on the story if you don't know it. Mark Dutroux is a pedophile who kidnapped and murdered several girls in the 90s. Those are only the ones we know about. It was a weird time around the 90s, like between, I want to say, 91 and 96. A lot of kids in Belgium went missing. I did a video on a few of those cases in one video. I'll link it Sick.